Okay, cool. Here we go. Welcome to another live stream. Today we're going to do a little bit of sketching. We're going to come up with a monster character. I'm not entirely sure what it's going to look like yet. We'll see where we get to. Okay, first things first. Simple pencil brush, pick a light grey. I'm just going to start sketching in some basic ideas. But initially, we're just kind of doing a few sort of thumbnails. So I have kind of sort of an idea of where I want to but we start off with a few simple thumbnails. We can explore a few different options. Yeah, these thumbnails are just kind of a nice way of just coming up with some ideas. Stick this over here. The moment we're just exploring different shapes. So I want to do a some kind of spider type creature. Not much I sort of know. I kind of want this thing to feel sort of really organic and that. Basically, this thumbnail process is just a way of trying different layouts, seeing what works. If it doesn't work in a simple form like this, it's probably not going to work in a more complicated form. I'm liking the idea of sticking to the four legs on this. Let's try something a bit different. Not a huge fan of that. Okay, so we're just gonna try a few different shades. Let's try a little bit wider at the bottom here. And most of the sketch today, we'll be using one brush. It's a custom brush that I use for quite a lot of the work that I do. It's a very rough brush. It's almost like a broken old paintbrush. So you can get kind of nice thick edges. You can get a few sort of rough edges. You can do some quite interesting stuff with it. Man, one of these that's speaking to me is this guy up here. So we're gonna stick that on another layer. Let's bring this guy in here to work up a little bit more. Stick the opacity of that layer down. That means we can draw over the top of it. The ink I'm using just a touch darker. I'm quite liking this basic shape of it, kind of flowing over to the front, with broken up at the top. And now we can start thinking about the actual structure of these legs a little bit more. little bit more dynamic. Okay, at the moment I'm still not worrying too much about getting the exact shapes right. You also notice that I'm only working in greys at the moment. This tends to be the way I start off most character illustrations. Don't use a hell of a lot of colour to begin with. The colour can come later on, but if the character works in basic greys, it's going to work nicely in colour. It's almost so you're not using colour as a compensation to make the character work. Another legging behind, so we've got six legs we're going on here. 100% on that, yeah, we'll see. But for this guy, I want. Let's try a couple of things with these eyes. Kind of big goofy things looking there. Not entirely sure I want that. Let's bang those out. Okay. Something around that. Kind of quite like that for the mouth. I want to do some really gnarly looking teeth in there. Again, this is very rough at this stage. A huge fan of these eyes. We want something a little bit more sinister looking. Because while this is going to be a sort of cartoon character, we still want a bit of realism to it. Okay, we also want this guy looking off over here a little bit more. A bit more of an angle, it's a little bit more dynamic. Okay. Let's lose our back layer. Right, here's our rough sketch to be getting on with. Okay, this is I think where we're going to be working from. Okay, so we're gonna boost up the size of this guy just a touch, so we've got a bit more room to work on. We'll bang this layer down to very low opacity, around about 20%, 15%, just so we can use this as a little guide. And then we're going to move in and start adding a few colours. Now we want to stick roughly to the kind of greens and browns. So we're going to go in sort of dark initially. I want my brush on 100% opacity at the moment up at the top. Now this guy, as we get into it, I want to look almost like he's made out of plants. So we're going to build up the textures, we're going to build up the detail, so this thing looks like it's almost grown out of the ground. Okay, so there we go. Our initial blocked in color. Excuse me. I'm going to stick down a bit darker there, stick opacity over to around about 40%, slightly below. And we can start building in some depth to this guy. Again, keep it nice and rough to begin with. I don't want to worry about too much detail. Put a bit of depth around the mouth. I want to get some shadow into the underside of this guy. This makes it feel. It's got a little bit more form. Yeah, I'm still sketching very, very rough here. We can tidy some stuff up a little bit later on. But I don't really want this character to look too neat. And getting him darker again. Building up a little bit of depth around the eyes. The eyes we'll come back to later with a bit more detail, but I want to start bringing in a few layers here around the mouth. You notice I'm using the same brush all the time, just adjusting the size as we go on. Using the shortcuts. When I'm drawing, I have a kind of a mini gaming keyboard set up. This kind of thing you have to the side of your normal keyboard when you're playing whatever game it is. But I have that set up with all of my Photoshop shortcuts. Resizing the brush, undo, that kind of stuff. So you're not mucking about with a full-size keyboard. Okay, here we go. Start building in a few little folds and creases. Oh, this guy's forehead, really furrowed. Let's add a few more bits of depth up here. So we're going to start building in a few little stray hairs there. Again, we're still on slightly below 40% opacity here. We're going to be going in with some some harder strokes in a little while. Again, sticking on the same color palette, just a little bit darker. Go. Adding more and more shading along the bottom edge. This guy's still nice and rough, but we're starting to bring in a few details. I'm going to start adding in a few cracks and creases along the lip here. And the same along the top. Just add a little bit of foam to these lips. Not moved away from single brush yet. This is the same thing. And we're just adjusting the size of this brush as and when we need to. I'm going to start bringing in a few cracks, a few finer details here. We want these to feel kind of organic, but still kind of quite rough. I mean, the trick is not to do anything too crisp, too clean. You want to sort of lead the eye around the character. It's kind of like one of my other tutorials. I show how to draw sort of cartoon teeth, expressions, that sort of stuff. One of the tricks is to actually not draw the teeth. It's to suggest that there's teeth there. A lot of when you're drawing like this is leaving in little suggestions so your eye fills in the rest of the detail. Okay, here we go. Nice. I'm just going to shift over to a slightly different, a lighter hue here. So still sticking in the same opacity. We don't want anything too harsh. We're just going to stick in a few more details here. Keep these nice and loose. I want it to feel nice and organic. And then along the edge of some of these kind of cracks and veins and whatever they are, add in a lighter green. And I'll starting to pick out a few finer details around the eyes, just where the character would catch the light. We're assuming the light is coming from somewhere up here where my logo is. So most of the lighting is over on this left hand side, and you start to pick out a few of these finer details that really bring the character to life. Again, we're keeping this on quite a low opacity, the brush, just for now. We'll go in with some more detailed, kind of harsher highlights shortly, but we want just the suggestions there at the moment, not anything too solid. Okay. Now we're gonna start banging these legs in. I'll knock this up to around about 80, somewhere between 80 and 90 opacity. I'm gonna stick another layer on over here, just in case we mess stuff up. And we're gonna start sketching in the basic form of these legs. Now, the knee joint. We don't want these to be hyper realistic or anything. But the best characters are always, the best monsters, sorry, are always based in reality. So if you base them on real creatures, or at least kind of real forms, if the character looks like it won't stand up, you automatically have kind of a disconnect. It's not going to work as a character. So you want your creatures, whatever they might be, to look like they'll actually work, to look like they'll function, and that way they'll be far more effective. Okay, so let's get another. These kind of weird little two-toed feet, right like that. Excuse me. Okay, we got another leg coming in up here. We've not got the teeth in yet. We'll add those in a little while. Gonna stick these legs in first of all. There I took another one back in here. At the moment, don't worry about kind of overlapping. We're going to go in and tidy a lot of that stuff up with highlights later on. Just making sure the form's right, make sure the character sits nicely. I think we want to stick in these extra legs at the back. Let's have a look how it looks. Yeah, I like the six legs. I'm not entirely sure actually, but I think the six legs look. Looks all right. There we go. Okay, and we've got another foot there. Okay, there we go. All we're going to come back in and we're going to start just tightening up a few of these shapes. Going to go right down to almost black, very, very dark green. So we're still on the same color spectrum, basically just using different shades of green. I'm going to start in a few of these darker areas. the moment, we're just adding in some texture. So picking out the darker points of these cracks. Picking out the darker areas between the eyes and the pits in this kind of slimy, organic sort of texture we've got going on with the skin. You'll see that the opacity of the brush is still up around about 80% here, which is why we're getting these slightly darker areas, picking out these shadows, and so we can really make these textures kind of pop out. Brush a bit smaller here. Start adding in a few more of these darker cracks along the lips. Okay, now we're going to go in and select the colour up here, and we want just ever so slightly darker, still up around 80%. Start getting a few more areas of texture. So we just want the skin to look a little bit more broken up, any of these smooth areas. In fact, if we stick this down to around about 30%, 29-30%, and get just a little bit more texture in there without really breaking up the those crisper lines. We don't need this to look too neat. Okay, I'm going to bang this right up to about 80-90% again. Let's select the colour we've got up here. And we're going to start working on a few more bits here, just to make this feel a little bit more organic. There's a few of these kind of chunky ends where you can see the brush shape a bit too much. I want to break those up, kind of want these like branches. By adding in those lighter areas first, you got a little bit of depth. So you start to see these shapes over the top. And again, we want to go a little bit darker again. And add in some nice dark areas here. Don't be afraid to do stuff kind of overlapping. It's the thing about kind of organic shapes, they're not overly structured. You want a bit of freedom there, you want a bit of looseness when you're drawing. We're going to come back into these legs here. Let's pick, see how dark we are down there. So we're going to go a few shades lighter. Mark it down to around about 60% and start picking out some of these areas. Just for some highlights and kind of suggesting some muscle shapes on the legs. We don't want too much in there. The back leg we're going to leave pretty much as it is. It's kind of back in the shadow. These front legs, we just want to start picking out a few little details. And this is where we start to build up the layers a bit more. Gonna this right on full on black there. So we can get a bit of shadow behind the leg here. Shadow on these back legs too. Start pick out some really dark bits around the eyes. And I'm going to add, well, we've got the black back here. I'm going to stick in a few really dark sort of branches up here. Okay, it's coming together quite nicely now. Save this while I remember. Okay. Let's see where we are. Right, we're going to lose that background layer. We're going to come in, we're going to address the mouth. So a new layer. What I'm going to do is using the lasso tool. It basically draw the basic shape of the mouth in there. Stick that in black. And now we're going to, again, using green, we're going to start blocking in some of these teeth. So stick it up to about 80%. Got your bigger brush size. And we're going to add some kind of some gums in there. Okay, so I get a bit of depth onto these. Okay, there's our basic gums for now. Just add a little bit more texture to them. Just around the corners, just for a bit extra shading in there. We'll be coming back to these in a little while once we've got the teeth in, because I need a wee bit of shading around them. But we're sketching roughly where we're going to have some teeth. These are where the teeth are going to sit into the gums. Okay, now we're going for a lighter green again, and we're going to start blocking in these teeth. Okay, let's bang this up to almost fully opaque, so I want to be up around about, let's see where we are, 95%, there we go. A nice solid brush, without being completely solid. We're going to start off sticking these bottom teeth in. Nice big nasty looking teeth down the bottom. Stick a few of these in the top. Now the top teeth we don't want quite as long. There we go. Cool, quite like that. Okay, now with these teeth, again, we just need to select a slightly darker green. We just start adding a little bit of depth in on these. So just on the inside, we're going to add a little strip of shadow. It's just to add a little bit of form to the teeth. Shadow on that one was hidden behind. Okay, now we're going to go in with quite a bit darker, smaller brush, bring this down to about 50%, 40, 50%. And we'll just sketch in a few finer details, a few kind of cracks up the teeth here as well. You also want to make the teeth sit into the gums. They don't really rest on top of the gums. They're embedded in there. So you want a bit of shadow around the bottom where the teeth are jammed into the gums there. Just a little hint of shadow makes these look like they're meant to be there. Drawing like this, a lot of the time it's like it's almost like painting in watercolor. So you're starting off with the lighter colors first of all, you go in darker and darker as you go. Same sort of principle. So you get in with these shades of green. and in just a moment, I'm going to go back in, same teeth, with a slightly darker green, just for the darker areas of shadow. So there we go. Select right down here. And let's just get those darker areas in. Make sure you do all the teeth, otherwise it'll look a bit weird. Yeah, you got teeth hidden behind, so you got a bit more shadow on there. While you're at it, you might want to do a few little bits over onto the gums, just to kind of give a bit of depth to these gums. So, a few little cracks and creases. Almost done on these. Also a few teeth. Looking pretty good. Okay, I'm going to deselect. Again with that real dark colour. I was going to make these gums sit into the mouth by dropping a heavy shadow over the top. And keeping the brush on around about 50%, so we can still get a few bits in there where it's not a solid black. You know, just sit back in the gums. Using the brush on a 50% opacity, we're just sticking in some more shadow around here, just where the gums would be casting, sorry, where the lips would be casting a shadow on the gums and the teeth, and then just a few slightly darker areas as the teeth fall back into the mouth or where a tooth overlaps. Not worried about getting it too perfect. There we go. Now we're going to shift across, start getting in a few of these heavy areas of black, so the bottom of that character. Again, we just want to work this up a little bit more, get a bit more depth. go. Just need a bit more shadow under here. Yeah, top of the character kind of falls over. This is where it's important to kind of consider the shadow and the highlights. Okay, we're going to stick another layer in. I'm going to take a look at these eyes. Now, first things first, we're going to actually do the same thing as with the mouth. Select these two areas where the eyes are going to be. First time we're going off the green palette here, we're going to go over to kind of a dirty yellow. Bang those in. Now keep the selection tool on there. Select an ever so slightly darker color. Stick your opacity down to 25-26%. I can start building in a few layers. Just get those shadows in there, getting slightly darker again. Slightly darker again. Okay, I just want to start building in these shadows, but nothing too neat. You want this still to look kind of organic. But by building up these different layers, you're starting to get a bit of depth on the eyes. Starting to sink them back into the head a little bit. Now, we want a pretty dark color here. Get these pupils in. Again, we've still got the opacity of the brush around about 25-26% because we don't want it to be too perfect. Bang out a couple of little highlights there. And again, the highlights at the moment are not fully white. Kind of an off-white. You can stick it up to fully white now. And pick out above those. Pick out a separate highlight as well. There we go, just on here. We'll add a little bit more on the eye here. And then, okay, now those eyes also need to sit into the head a little bit more. So we're going to stick this dark green on. Keeping the opacity of the brush around about 25-26%. And just start building up a few layers. Where the eyelids are overlapping the eyes, casting a bit of shadow on those eyeballs. While we're at it, pick out a few more details. Just keep finding areas where we want a little bit more texture. We don't really want any of this to look too flat. So if there's areas that look like there's just a solid block of colour, just want to mix those up a bit. I'm going to add in a few cracks and creases to the eyes. Okay, I'm going to pick out up on the top here, add another layer. We've got selected very, very light green, somewhere around about there. It's a lime green. We're up at 23%, 26% at the moment, sorry. I'm going to go up to around about 40%. I'm going to start just picking out a few of these bright highlights. These are the areas that just really do catch the light. You got to be careful at this stage. Don't want to go kind of go overkill, but just a few little highlights here and there, areas of the character that are sticking a bit further forward, that are catching the light, and these are really going to start bringing your character to life. So is where we pick out a few bright spots on the lips as well. Branches or hairs, whatever they are, coming in here. Again, don't worry too much about making this neat. You want these to be picked out over the top. Just add a little bit more depth to the character. Try to do things too precise, it's just going to look terrible. Around the eyes there, just where the light is catching the lid. Got a couple of these on the legs that are at the front as well. Don't worry about the ones further back. We want them to look like the further back, so they're not catching quite as much light. So just a few bits and pieces on here. Nothing too detailed again. Okay, now. Quickly while we're here, I'm going to bang this up to 80 odd percent. Just tidy up the edge here a little bit. I want a solid, a bit more of a solid line. Doesn't have to be perfect at all, but just a little crisper there. Okay, I'm going to stick another layer on. We're going to pick almost white, almost pure white. And with this, I'm going to start picking out the real highlights on the teeth. You just want a few little bits and pieces. I mean, you don't want to go overkill with this. You can quite easily mess up your character by sticking in too many highlights. It's just going to look like it's covered in glitter, but you want enough kind of shine on the eyes, any of these areas of real highlights. Again, you see I've got the brush at around about 85%, so these are really solid highlights. Rarely work on character sketches with the brush at more than 85% at any point. As soon as you have it set at 100%, it's too solid. It loses a bit of that organic feel. Okay, there we go. A few little highlights around the mouth. Lips to look kind of a little bit wet, so and a few droplets on there. Adding in a few bits of saliva hanging from the teeth. Nothing too much, just a few little details here and there. And there we go. Think we can leave that for today. In fact, let's just stick a very rough shadow underneath just to settle this guy into the ground a little bit. Go for a larger brush. Just want to sit him back. And with that, pick a rubber and go for a softer edged brush. Stick that down to about 29, and we'll just soften off the edges of this shadow. And there we go. There we go. Monster concept art. Around about 45 minutes. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.